Good day! All the way from the Bulacan Agricultural State College, I am your presenter, Geliza Jaslen G. Elopre, and I am here to show everyone our technology-based instructional materials for fourth grade English lesson about basic elements of a short story. Let me take the helm and be your captain for this one-of-a-kind journey to our learning is an adventure with technology-based instructional materials. The pandemic brought hardships and challenges to each one of us. It's as if with just a snap of a finger, everything changed. And this inevitable shift demands flexibility and adaptability. One of the most affected sectors of this is the educational sector. The pandemic pushed us back to our homes and restricted us from going back to schools. However, our thirst for knowledge will always be present, and it is the teachers' duty to quench them. We face a lot of setbacks and hurdles with the implementation of online distant learning. The air was filled with doubts and hesitations. The students and teachers alike have never encountered such setup that leaves us questioning the status of education here in the Philippines. However, as educators, we must step up our game. We must be the embodiment of confidence. We must radiate the fighting spirit that we can jump over the hurdles presented in front of us. Challenges are made to challenge our strengths and adaptability. Thus, one of the best ways to guide our students in the right path throughout this new normal setup is with the use of technology. We must be able to utilize these resources we have today so that we can incorporate them in our lessons. In this way, we can create instructional materials that are innovative, interactive, and interesting. Therefore, we are here to present our very own technology-based instructional materials for teaching. Let us take a look at the preparation for our technology-based instructional material.
Thank you.
since students might be very familiar and were aware of the use of slide deck presentation. It is easy to manipulate, access, and also offers a lot of potential to becoming a quality instructional material. We use the PowerPoint presentation to create our motivational game before the start of the formal discussion. This will help the teachers to hook the attentions of their students and make them listen. We need to consider the grade level of the students we will teach so that we can adjust the style of our IM. In our case, we are teaching grade 4 students, so we need to create a visually attractive and appealing presentation. This will also challenge the minds and curiosity of the students, because the motivation we created is connected to the main lesson and the activity after that. We utilized the different tools available in the PowerPoint presentation, like combined shape, hyperlink, and transitions. The lesson proper should be brief, but still interactive. The students, especially children, have a shorter attention span, so we need to be brief and concise with our lesson. Of course, without sacrificing the fun of learning. Transitions and text box, shape union, combine, and animation were used in our lesson. Afterwards, we need to apply what they learned. In the activity part, we created an audiovisual book. This consists of our original written story, original character designs, music, and also voiceover. We aim to present a unique and personally made story to the children that teaches them good values as well. We believe that using this audiovisual book, we will enhance the creativity, imagination, and also help the learners identify the basic elements of a short story.
The treasure. One day, they went into the woods in search for a possible place where a treasure might be.
Let us go in different directions so that when one of us finds something, we can just call the others,
said Ella.
Sure, in that way, we can find the treasure easily,
Jack agreed.
Then I will be going this way,
Sophie declared and went on her own. The three adventurers searched high and low for a treasure that they can take home. Unfortunately, Jack only found some fruits from the trees, while Ella saw beautiful flowers blooming in the forest. Luckily, Sophie was able to spot something glimmering and sparkling from a distance. She excitedly ran towards where it is.
Next, as teachers, we need to evaluate if our students were able to learn our lesson. We prepared a short quiz that is connected to the story in the audiovisual book we showed them. Shape, transition, text box, animation, and also hyperlink were used. Finally, we decided to end it with an assignment that will further challenge our students about the lesson and will promote independent learning and also kinesthetic development. Technology-based instructional materials are easy to use and manipulate. As teachers, this will benefit us because even at home, or in face-to-face setup, we can create them with just the right formula at hand. The students will be offered a much more entertaining and interactive mode of learning that will help them with their development. The pandemic is an eye-opener for every one of us that life is about living the moment and seizing it. We need to give our utmost effort with everything that we do. In that way, we can slowly but surely move past challenges and create a better future. That's all, and thank you very much.